Hello everyone and welcome to another After Effects tutorial. My name is Tyler Bradway and this is Creativid Studios. Today I'm going to be showing you how to make a hologram in After Effects different from the original hologram I made like 2 years ago. This one is going to have like kind of like receding volumetrics where the hologram itself looks like it's coming from the projector and not just like having like a glow basically. Okay, so to do this, we're gonna link the anchor point to a null object and then duplicate the layer a bunch of times, scaling each one down smaller than the previous. And we're gonna blend all those together and add some finishing touches like a glow and adjusting some transparencies. And then we'll have our final hologram. So let's hop into this tutorial. First things first, take your footage and pull it into a new composition. I usually do that just by pulling it into this button right here. And as you can see, it's already got an alpha channel or transparency. And this is just an Ewok I found in my backyard. I already have the transparency basically because I already keyed it out. I didn't want to go through the process of green screening in this video because I've already made a video for that. So if you're interested in that after this video, you might want to check that out. We want to actually pull this composition into a new composition, or you could do layer precompose. And we just do that so that at any point, if we want to replace our original footage, since we're duplicating this, we want to have all instances of this footage change. So that's just a quick way to do that. So obviously we're going to duplicate this, like I said. And on this top layer, we're going to make it look all glitchy by adding, well, not glitchy, but like old school interlaced video kind of like stuff. We're going to do that with Venetian blinds. We're just going to plop that on the top layer. And if we solo it, we'll change this to 50. Whoa, what the heck happened? We'll change this to 50% complete. And obviously, scan lines don't go vertical. They go horizontal. So we'll change this to 90 degrees. And the width can be thinner, like 10 pixels. But if we turn on the bottom layer, it doesn't look any different because they're the same colors. So what I did was I added a toner to this top layer and changed the color to be like a blue. So it kind of like does two things at the same time. It like adds a bluish tint to it as well as making scan lines. Next, we're going to want to get rid of all the areas that have black because holograms don't have black in them. They're just made out of light, right? You do Command-Alt-Y to add a new adjustment layer, or you could do Layer, New, Adjustment Layer. Yeah, right there. And we're going to add Unmult. This is kind of like taking a Lumamat and then removing all the areas that were black. So, that's what it did. It removed all the areas that are black and changed them to transparent. Obviously, it's hard to see it right now because this transparency grid's on. So I'll just shut that off and we can see our footage. So let's bring our footage into a new composition again by pulling it into this thing. And we'll rename this layer by hitting Command K or Control K if you're on Windows. And we'll name it Hologram. Let's make this hologram all glitchy like and transition on. So like sort of glitch on. To do that, I'm gonna make a new solid. I'm just gonna do Command Y to open new solid. Doesn't matter what color. So we're gonna add fractal noise to it. Oh, that's a small one. Command Y. Make it the comp size, hit OK, and we're going to add fractal noise to it, and we'll make it rocky and a block noise type. Change the noise, I mean the contrast to 500, and the brightness to -250 on the first frame. Next we'll make a keyframe on the first frame for brightness, then like 10 frames in. Mine says 1 second in. That's because it doesn't start on the first frame for whatever reason. And then we'll just make this positive 250 so it's all white. And so we have a keyframe for black and a keyframe for white. And in between, it animates on. But let's add some more noisiness to this. We can do that first. I kind of want to scale this up, though, a little bit, just so it's more noticeable. And then we'll Option or Alt-click the... So technically, it's Option on Max, but everyone just says Alt. So let's just say Alt. You Alt-click the evolution to... You Alt-click the stopwatch next to evolution, and it brings up this expression control thing down here. So we'll just, let's delete this and type time times 3,000, just to make it go really quickly. So it's multiplying the time in seconds that it's on by 3,000 to get this value. And it looks like it glitches. And then we can take these, Command C to copy, and go over here to the end and Command V to paste. Obviously Control C and Control V on a Windows. And then we're gonna wanna reverse these keyframes because it's the end. So we'll do time reverse keyframes. And blah, 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 blah. Okay, so next we'll change the track mat to Luma mat for this bottom layer, and it glitches on. Yay! Okay, so now we can bring this into yet another composition and rename this composition to be maybe like projected hologram. And on this projected hologram, we're gonna need to be able to control the anchor point, like I said. So we'll do layer new, null object, and we're going to use this null object as a control. We'll name it projector, because this is basically going to act like where the projection's coming from. So say you had tracked a projector in your footage or whatever, some background footage. Use the null for this purpose, to be the projector. Okay. So next, we want to control the anchor point. So we hit A to open both these. And then we Alt-click the anchor point in the hologram layer and pick-whip the project. Actually, we don't need the anchor point on this one. But we pick-whip the projector layer, not the position or the anchor point. And we type the following expression, period, 2, comp, open parentheses, open bracket, 0, comma, 0, comma, 0, close bracket, close parentheses, semicolon. And now what that does is every time we move this, when we move this null, it's going to move the anchor point of the footage, but it's changing the position relative to the composition, and we don't want that. So we'll open P on both these by selecting them both and hitting P, which is position. And we'll Alt-click the position, pick-whip the position. This will compensate for the movement. So now if we move this, it stays in this, the footage stays in the same spot, but the null pulls the anchor point over to the side. I'm just going to hit U to close out the stuff that was open, and we'll duplicate this layer, Command D, and duplicate it one more time because we need two 100% scale ones. And then we'll, on this third one, let's hit S to bring up scale and change it to 90%. And I'm going to move this null over, and you're going to see it changes relative to the null. So the more duplicates we make, and the more like scaled duplicates we make, the better this effect will work, and like you'll see what's going on. So duplicate this bottom layer again and switch it to 80%, and we keep doing increments of 10 until we get down to 20%, at which point we're going to change it to increments of 5. Okay, now that we have all our duplicates, we're able to basically move this null, and they will move according to that null. This is the basic shape of our projection, but we have to blend these together because obviously you can see all the individual layers. So we got to blend these together to make it look like volumetric light. So we'll above. Let's just pull this top layer above the null so we don't forget this layer is the actual hologram. All these other layers are part of the light projector. And let's make an adjustment layer above these holograms. So these ones, do Command Alt Y to make a new adjustment layer. And we'll type in vector blur. This is what we're gonna use to blur these together. If we just turn it up now, it looks like mush. I usually do like 350 here. That's because we gotta add a vector map. And we don't have a vector map yet. So the vector map's gonna tell the blur where to, in what direction to blur the footage. So we're gonna want it to blur towards this point. To do that, we're gonna need to make a gradient, a radial gradient at that point. So we do layer new solid, doesn't matter the color again, and we'll do ramp. And that will bring up gradient ramp, which we want. We'll change it to radial and swap the colors because we want the white to be at the center. Next, we'll move this end of ramp over to the side, like that. And then for this start of ramp, we alt click it and pick whip the position of the null, which isn't open right now, so I gotta open that by hitting P. Then just pick whip that position, click off of that, and now if we move the null, the projector, it's going to change where the gradient goes. Okay, so let's shut off this gradient ramp because all we need is the luminance information from it. And we'll go back into our adjustment layer and switch the vector map to our solid, which is the gradient. And we also have to change the effects, the source, the whatever this dropdown is, into effects and masks, so that it looks at the effect, which was the ramp. And now you can see it's starting to blend it together, but it doesn't do it all the way, because you can see like individual layers still. And by increasing this, we can't really, watch, I'll demonstrate. If you increase this, it's still the same problem. So what you gotta do is add another vector blur, and sometimes even more than two. But this looks like it's working. Next, we will take all these hologram layers, not these layers, and hit T to open up transparency. Just make it like 65-ish, between 60 and 75, I think. Actually, I want this top one to be brighter, so I'll do 75. And so let's animate our position of the projector. We can do that obviously by just changing the position over time with keyframes obviously being set for each position. Let's add a glow. Command Alt Y to add a new adjustment layer above everything. And we'll type in glow and add it. Lower the intensity to like 0.05 or 0.5. And then increase the radius. And increase the threshold to be like almost 100%. Because this is really white footage. But in other footage, it might not matter so much. I'm just going to decrease the intensity a little more just by lowering the opacity of this adjustment layer to like 70. Okay. So, with some color correction and obviously comping it into your background footage, you'll have yourself a hologram. That's it for this tutorial, guys. I hope you learned something. So, if you enjoyed this tutorial, be sure to like and share it on social media, and subscribe to my YouTube channel for more.